think Mr. President, it's good morning.
Good to be here.
It's so nice to know.
Thank you.
It's really.
She's astounded the doctor. Well, it's good to see you. I think we have to come in and small talk for a while while some three waves of photographers. You remember that.
That's right, yes.
Well.
How did we go?
Glad to see you, sir.
Nice to see you again. All right.
Where do we sit?
Yes, there. Same to same place. Sit down.
Gentleman over there is Denver Cody Pop.
First time I stand over here while the press is in. You don't mind me?
Nice to be in the room.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
It's very nice to have you. I have much with the stock market behaving the way it is.
Yes, sir.
Some of our press will be shouting questions at me in spite of our questions ordered. This I.
President, the Democrats say that it's your economic policies that caused that downturn on Wall Street yesterday.
Yes, it's funny, Bill, that I couldn't understand at the beginning that creating 14 million new jobs, eliminating inflation, or virtually eliminating it, bringing it down, and lowering interest rates, increasing the prosperity of the people, I just wouldn't understand that that could hurt the stock market.
What worries would you have for investors today, Mr. President?
Well, we're in constant consultations. I think everyone has been caught by surprise in this. And it is true that at this point of the day, the market is a far better situation than it was yesterday at this time, with about the same number of sales of stock, or trading of stock. But I'm very pleased and gratified with the action that has been taken so far by the Federal Reserve Board. And the fact that two of the major banks have lowered their interest rates.
Are you having meetings here today with your economic advisors, Secretary Baker?
I can't speak to that, Bill, right now. I do know that we've been in continuous consultations, and many times they come up without advanced scheduling.
Mr. President, some on Wall Street say they want some leadership from the White House. They want some action on the budget deficit. They want to calm the fears about the Persian Gulf. What do you have to say to them? Is there going to be any action by this administration, or are you set to just let the market run its course at this point?
Well, as I told you, we are consulting continuously and have been since this started with others in our own administration, but also outside forces. With regard to the deficit, then why don't they fix the blame, as I have tried to, where it belongs, on the legislature, which has gone on now for more than 50 years, defending deficit spending.
Thank you.
This way, please. Cameras.
When's the news coming? When's the news coming?
I thought you'd know. I don't know. I know that it's soon.
This way.
Good dress.
Can we have a hand, please? Thank you. Thank you, President.
Pleasure.
How is Nancy?
Not just fine.
Glad to hear that.
Two of the most handsomest men in the world, Jay.
What's that?
Two of the most handsomest men in the world.
I don't know about the Prime Minister, but you just made my day.
I told you our press would be nicer than yours.
Would you like to go to work in our press corps?
It's the last wave, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it.
Discuss all having to do with the excellent relationship exists between our two countries.
Thank you very much.
They will compromise something, I'm sure.
Guys, I kept the Prime Minister in there a little longer than we were supposed to be there. And when we leave here, it'll be a short meeting here, but we'll continue meeting over lunch. Maybe a working lunch. But you are all most welcome, and I've been discussing with your Prime Minister how our bilateral relationship has improved so substantially since your visit in 1985, and I think we're on the right track. And I want to reiterate my strong support for India's integrity. We share an abhorrence of terrorism, and I'm glad we've been able to cooperate in combating the Sikh terrorists who are seeking to use our country as a base. delighted to receive your letter also stating India's desire to purchase a supercomputer for monsoon research, and I've already told the Prime Minister we shall proceed with cooperation on aspects of your light combat aircraft, though I haven't mentioned that in there, that project also. But you must also have an agenda there that I should pause myself and...
Thank you, Mr. President. May I first thank you, Commissioner, for the invitation that you extended. And it's a great pleasure to be in the United States and to have this opportunity to meet with you again. Especially as you have so many problems and preoccupations just during these days, we appreciate your taking the stand. Thank you. The visit in many ways, although very brief, is very timely. We had, 2 years ago, set out on a course of action to bring the two countries closer together. And I'm very glad that today we can look back and answer those very skeptical comments that had come at that time. We have achieved everything that we set out to do, and it's time to lay out a new agenda for us to work out, to move ahead on. I believe that our two groups have already been talking to each other, and much of that has already been done. We appreciate again the cooperation and understanding that we have received.
I'm 16.
Every once in a while, my past life catches up with me. So, with this being trading partners as we are, I have been importuned to speak about